The first one is expansion. Well, this is the other main one, really. So when you go into a building that has a metal roof, next time you're in one, have a listen when the sun comes out from behind a cloud and it starts to heat up the roof. So when it's cloudy, the roof, the metal in the roof is quite cool. But then as soon as heat energy from the sun, so the sun sends rays of light and they cause the roof to get hotter. As soon as that happens, the particles in the roof, they start to vibrate a bit more. They vibrate back and forwards, and that makes the whole roof expand a little bit. So when we had a cool roof to start with, the particles are arranged neatly and they're not moving too much. But when they heat up a little bit, because they're vibrating back and forwards, they take up more space because they're pushing into each other and bumping, and the metal actually spreads apart. So when the roof expands, it pushes against all the bolts in the roof and you can hear it creaking and cracking. And that's what the sound is when the sun hits a metal roof. And another example that's really a problem in Melbourne in summer is railway lines. They can also expand when they get too hot. So on really hot days, like above 40 degrees, the metal in the railway lines expands because of heat. So where the railway lines might have just been a certain length, they expand a little bit. But because they're bolted down, they actually bend instead of just getting longer. And that causes these bends in the train tracks, and they can't be repaired. We have to cut them off and put in new tracks. So on summer days, sometimes a whole train line can get shut down because of that. And the last example you might have seen expansion is in thermometers, where they actually use expansion, but of a liquid to help show the temperature. So liquids can expand as well when they get hotter. And expansion happens for liquids and gases too. So a thermometer, it has a red colored dye, and at a cold temperature, those particles aren't moving very much, and so they don't take up as much space. But then when heat energy comes in and the liquid gets hotter, it expands upwards. And so the liquid takes up more space, and that means the top of the marker goes higher on the thermometer, so we can read the temperature.